Good morning, children. In yesterday's class, you learned about the pollen grain, how it is formed. So, pollen dust from hibiscus plant or hydrax plant, we have collected, and when it is observed under the microscope, we are going to see the structure like this. Okay? It will be there like this. When it is ready to germinate, so you know that the pollen grain, when it reaches the stigma of ova, or that is stigma of gynoecium, then only it starts germinating. So before that, what is happening? So this microscopic mother cell, it undergoes repeated mitotic cell divisions and further meiotic cell division, and it is going to form like this structure. Okay, and it contains the two nuclei. Is it clear to you? So out of these two nuclei, one is going to fuse with the egg cell in the female gametophyte, and the other one is going to fuse with the central cell. So how that process is going to happen? To understand that process of fertilization, before that we have to learn about the structure of a female gametophyte, that is a structure of ovule. To understand the process of pollination and fertilization, we have to know the female reproductive part of the plant, flower, that is a flower, structure of ovule. Okay, so this is the structure of a gynoecium, is it not? So now, so gynoecium contains three important parts: stigma, ovary, and this long tube like structure, stylet. Okay, and here the ovule is present inside, and this ovule is attached to the flower. So we have drawn like this structure, no children, at the center. So here we can see the floral parts like this, is it not? So all these floral parts, especially ovary, is attached. So this portion is a cushion like structure, which we call it as a thalamus. So this ovule is said to be egg shaped, and depending upon the species of plants, so different plant species are there. In all the different plant species, this ovules may be 1 or 2 or 3 or hundreds or even thousands also, like that, many in a number. Then at the center of the cell, we are going to observe a ovule. Inside that, we are going to observe a female gametophyte, which female gametophyte or embryo sac. This embryo sac contains even food and water also is storing, and the group of cells are also seen here. So that one here it is mentioned. So if we take only this structure, that is a female gametophyte, which is developed from the ovule. Okay, so repeated mitotic division and one meiotic division is going to develop, which helps in the formation of female gametophyte. So this female gametophyte contains three groups of cells. So what are those three groups of cells? The anterior region, antipodals are there, and here we observe two synergids and one egg cell, and central cell. Why it is present at the center? But number of nuclei, if we observe, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is it clear to you? So, 8 nuclei are present. 8 nuclei are present. So, now, what is the function of antipodals and synergids? Okay? Now, please understand what I am saying. So, this antipodals and synergids are going to provide nourishment to the developing embryo after the fertilization. Is it clear to you? So, they are going to provide nourishment. So, this egg cell and polar nuclei which are present at the central cell. XL is present very much close to this thalamus region. So what is happening here, after the fertilization this antipodals and synergids are going to be fall off. So this antipodals move to the anterior region and the synergids move to the micropyle region here. Okay, so this is about the female gametophyte. So now how the process of fertilization is going to happen? So when the pollen dust falls here on the stigma of the ovule or gynoecium, the develops a tube like structure and dividing the nucleus whichever is present into tube, and the pollen tube extends continuously like this, and here it is going to reach the through micropylar region, and first fertilization is going to happen with the one male nuclei of the pollen grain is going to fuse here with the egg cell, and that one we call it as a first fertilization, and the other nuclei whichever is there it is going to fuse with the polar nuclei. Okay, so now here diploid zygote is formed after the fertilization, and the second time other nuclei whichever is reaching through the micropylar region, it reaches the central cell, and where it is going to fuse with the polar nucleus. So already here the condition of the cells is a diploid, is it clear to children? So second time fertilization is going to happen, so it is said to be the double fertilization. Is it clear to you? So almost all flowering plants we are going to observe a common characteristic feature, that is a double fertilization in plants. What is the meaning of double fertilization? First time the main nuclei from the pollen grain whichever is formed all the way it reaches micropylar region, and it is going to fuse with the egg cell, that is female gamete. So that is called first fertilization. Second nucleus whichever is formed that is going to fuse with the polar nuclei of a central cell. Is it clear to you? So that's why it is called as a double fertilization. After fertilization, so many changes are going to happen in the floral parts. Calyx and corolla, they perish off. Sometimes we observe calyx also, which are attached to the fruit, and ovule is going to change into ovary is going to change into fruit, and ovules are going to be converted to seeds. Is it clear to children? That we will discuss how it is happening tomorrow.